Welcome to the Steuber Classic Croquet Tournament at the National Croquet Center in West Palm Beach, Florida. This tournament honors Chuck Steuber, who's the fellow who got the National Croquet Center built. This is the golf croquet section, and it features Sherif Abdelwahab at a golf croquet handicap of -3 against Mark Kucharski, whose golf croquet handicap is 4. Mark is from the Sapphire Country Club in North Carolina, up in the mountains, where the Golf Croquet National Championships are being held in May of this year. Sherif, of course, is the pro at the National Croquet Center, has multiple national championships, and was inducted into the Hall of Fame this weekend. Tournament director is Carla Rueck, and your videographer is Paul Neubecker. All 4 balls are now in play. Why Mark didn't unload both barrels on that blue ball, I don't know, because to assume that Sherif was going to miss this shot is wishful thinking, as he demonstrated. The scoreboard is going to show which ball made each hoop all the way through the game. I'm experimenting with different formats here, so let me know in the comments whether you like this or not. Wiley, an expert croquet, suggests that expert players have an obligation to entertain, to make the game interesting for everybody. You're going to see in this game that Sherif takes that obligation very seriously. Reg Bamford likes to refer to what Sherif's about to do as a Barnes Wallace bouncing bomb shot. Look up Barnes Wallace and you'll see what he's talking about. Mark has a lovely fluid swing motion, but he casts 6 to 9 times for each shot, so I cut a lot of that casting out. Thank you. Scoring in golf croquet is a little like tennis, of course. If you have the first shot in the game, then all you really have to do is hold serve because you don't have to win by two. Ordinarily, you would think about setting up with your first ball and clearing with your second ball. But I think red is wired from black by hoop four. So he needs to get it out of there with yellow now. He probably meant to go a little bit farther and block Red's hoop shot. We're on court six at the National Croquet Center. That tent is there temporarily just for the Hall of Fame dinner. Ordinarily, you get a really nice view of the veranda from here. So black's wired from red by the hoop, and it's far enough from blue that if yellow clears blue, we probably can't pick up black in the same shot. Black, red flags. I don't have any other games on video from the golf croquet section of this tournament, but with Sherif at minus three, a couple other guys in the zero range, and then Mark at a four handicap, he has had a fabulous tournament to get into the final against Sherif.
It's 4-2.
Yeah, I think it's 4-2.
Second game or first game?
First game.
Thank you.
Hello to flags.
And where is the champion, the national
That yellow ball is a long way from the hoop, but Sherif has respect for Mark's hoop shooting ability, and he's going to try to take it out.
Four, two, favorite blue, black, red play, corner wicket.
Looks like Mark's playing with a Oakley Woods Predator.
Yeah.
And it's serving him well. Thank you. Ooh, he's making it interesting now from 5-3 to 5-all. Those announcements by somebody right next to the microphone are for the game on court 5, I think. Loose hoops are harder to make than firm hoops because they absorb the energy instead of reflecting it. Sherif does that a lot, but why he did it there, I don't know, because he's not going to try to make this hoop with this ball. The blue has to clear red now, and I'd be willing to bet that Sherif is thinking about where he wants blue to end up on this shot. Because now, if red makes hoop 12 on the next shot and ties it up, blue is legally offsides up there by hoop 13, all ready to go.
Yeah, that's why you gotta hit it with pace.
So Mark takes Sherif all the way to hoop 12, where Sherif takes the game 7-5. Game 2 to follow immediately, and the loser of game 1 starts game 2 with either ball of his side. It almost looks like he can do an in-off and score the hoop, but he hits right on the other side and sends it to corner 3 instead. And now, seeing no real reason to clear red because blue plays first, I'm pretty sure he's planning on putting black in position at hoop 2 by taking it off the left side of yellow. So, he hit the wrong side of yellow. He's legally offsides, but he's a long way from where he wanted to be.
Let's see. yesterday in my 6 foot game against Rich Curtis. I was in the jaws.
Two guys extend their hands, congratulate each other on that match. One guy goes like this. Is that a sign of victory or defeat? Sometimes it's a random.
Yeah, that's funny. Looks like it's through.
Yep.
Top we go. Shot.
They must not be in contact, otherwise Sherif could do whatever he wanted without risk of double tap. Ignoring, of course, for the purposes of golf croquet, that almost all split shots are in fact double taps.
Thank you.
Told them they start after us, so you can get the whole game. I know you want to.
Yeah, that's what I think of that. Yeah.
6. You're going to 3 back, which is the southeast black corner. Blue's good. Blue's good. You're going to that corner.
Not only is he on the board, he's trying to mount a comeback.
Seven, 6, blue to play, this is fun. Seven, red to play, northwest corner. Thank you.
Mark's not giving up.
Middle.
But as worthy an opponent as Mark Kucharski has turned out to be, fulfilling his widely mandated obligation to entertain from over 65 feet away. Sherif takes game 2-7-3 to win the golf croquet division of the 2022 Steuber Classic.